ladies and gentlemen, I'm Bethany Dorman. But a couple weeks ago, I was told you can't say ladies and gentlemen anymore. So it reinforces the gender binary, right? So,
yeah.
So I was like, well, what the fuck? What do I say? I said, you say folks.
Yeah.
Now, I'm a little bit old school, right? So like, there's a bit of like theatrical gravitas to ladies and gentlemen, right? And I was like, folks. Be a better solution, and so I came up with it. This isn't even really comedy, actually. I just love saying it. It's like, ladies, etc. So this is actually my first time doing stand-up. So be gentle. It's my first time. I've always wanted to say that. Don't set the bar too high, because there's no new comedy, because human beings just keep doing the same stupid shit over and over and over again, you know? So anyways, for those of you who are wondering, I am, in fact, a bisexual trans woman, so put your cameras away, we exist. And as a bisexual trans woman, you know what that means, right? That means I'm not getting twice as much sex as you're not getting. I am in fact single, but I make up for being single for like the lack of attention by just scheduling doctor's appointments. Which is nice, but just for the record, when you go back for your test results, do not refer to that as a second date. It totally comes to the phone. And incidentally, it turns out you don't have to get undressed if you go back for the test results. Which was additionally creepy because it was at my therapist's. So, yeah. But now, you know, I'm getting older now. I'm 43.
Yeah. I think so good.
So, you know, you're in the doctor all the time. So I see my doctors more than I see my friends now, you know? But I started to think of going to see the doctor a lot like I'm going to court to find out how much I'm losing in the divorce, you know? And then she's like, well, Daphne, I'm sorry, but you're gonna have to give up dairy. And I'm like, not a dairy, bitch! I know, like half of you are vegan. I wasn't always single, though, you know? My ex and I broke up shortly after I came out, about 3 years ago. Although, to be fair, I came out hokey pokey style. Like, I put my right leg out, I put my right leg back, I put my left leg out. But once I put my whole body out, I was out! I've been pretty much out ever since then, and that just didn't really work for my ex, you know? I wasn't so much interested in having a dick, she was very interested in being one.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Really, really was a pretty shitty breakup. I mean, I know no breakups are easy. Relationships are a lot like massages that way. Not everybody gets the happy ending, you know what I mean? But I live in San Francisco. So that means I'm surrounded by a lot of very smart, very wise people. So they were like, hey, Daphne, look, it's really simple. Here's what you gotta do. You gotta get back in touch with yourself. You gotta meditate. You gotta go to therapy. So I meditated and I went to therapy. And they were like, you know what you gotta do? You gotta get back to nature. Go do some hiking. Try the hot yoga. So I did the hiking and I tried the hot yoga. And then they were like, no, you gotta cleanse yourself. You gotta eat some granola and drink some kombucha. So I ate the granola. That's where I drew the line. I don't know what the hell this shit is. But, you know, I was really skeptical at first with all their advice, you know, all the things you're supposed to do. But in retrospect, I look back on it now and I'm really glad that I did. Like, that I took that time to, like, get in touch with myself and find some peace and be one with the universe. Because at the end of it all, you know what I realized? My ex is a total bitch. really interesting. I don't know if anybody here has ever come out. Nice, yeah, kudos to all of you. I didn't know this beforehand, actually, but it turns out coming out is really nothing more than an invitation for everybody else to come and tell you what they think about you coming out. Like, for the most part, it doesn't. Most people are what I call id gaffes, right? I don't give a fuck. They're like, I'm transgender. They're like, I have a bunion, pass the peanuts. Whatever. They don't give a crap, right? And then there's like the overly supportive people. You know these people, right? You're like, oh, I'm transgender. And they're like, Daphne, you are just the most beautiful creature of pure soulful light I've ever met. Now I have my days. But usually it's like the day when my makeup is half smeared and my, my hair is all matted down and everything. I'm like, this is not my day. This is not the day when I'm the beautiful soul of light, right? But the ones who really get me are those, like, conservative ones, and they're like, Jesus died on the cross for your sins! Jesus died on the cross for your sins! And I'm like, Jesus was a little bit of a drama queen then, wasn't he? I feel like a note from my doctor would have sufficed. Pretty crazy. Like, people really get bent out of shape about the whole transgender thing. Maybe it's because I'm, like, visibly transgender, but I was at Denny's this one time, and this guy came over and he's like, you're a faggot, you're a tranny, blah, 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 and then he spit right in my spaghetti. Right? And it's fucking me. I was like, that's so crazy. And it's really, here's the difference. So when I tell my cisgender friends about that, they're like, that's so fucking horrible. I can't believe that. That's the worst thing. I'm so sorry you have to deal with this. And then I tell my transgender friends that, and they're like, bitch, who the fuck orders spaghetti in Denny's? Yeah. That's really funny. I have a friend who's kind of new to San Francisco and is telling her that story. And she's like, where is there a Denny's? Political turmoil, and we've got these political events going on and everything. I've discovered that if you go to the really, like, the religious conservative ones, and then somebody comes up to you and they're like, what are you doing here? I point to the candidate and I'm like, I'm here to support my boyfriend. And I hold up a sign that's like, Jeff, why don't you call me anymore? I know I'm knocking people who are supportive with that, oh, Daphne, you're so, but I actually really do like supportive people. And I especially like it when they compliment me on something that isn't, like, inherent. It's like a skill that, when somebody's like, Daphne, your makeup is really on point today. Or Daphne, I love your hair. Or Daphne, you dress like a hooker. And I'm always like, well, dress for the job you want, not the job you have. Because the job I have is software engineer. Yeah. So nobody's ever expecting that. Well, obviously, you're going to have to reset your server. So I like to push the boundaries a little bit in my office. I apologize to my coworkers. I like to push those boundaries a little bit. Like when my friends come up to me in the office and they're like, I'm like, you should just be glad I'm not wearing only thigh high boots. I think if I had to summarize, like, my entire fashion aesthetic, like, in one phrase, it would be, are you cold? I gotta admit, though, I have to admit, I really like making shitloads of money. Basically the invasive species of San Francisco. Yeah. We're just choking off the life and culture that's here, you know? But I actually thank God for tech. Because if it wasn't for tech, I have no idea what the hell some of these motherfuckers would be doing. Do you know, like, some people are just so right for the job that they have. Like, what would you do if you weren't programming and being deleted? I think some celebrities fall into this a little bit. Like Gordon Ramsay. I love that that's all I had to say. Gordon Ramsay is doing exactly the job that he's supposed to do, right? Like, can you imagine Gordon Ramsay as your gynecologist? One thing you do not want is Gordon Ramsay yelling, "You're a fucking twat," into your fucking twat. You don't make that sound. So, you know, I've noticed here in the Bay Area, by the way, that the sun is... It's a little bit like that that bitchy friend of yours who always wants you to go out clubbing, but then disappears the moment you go to the bar for drinks. Like, I'm over ordering drinks, and then I turn around, and the sun is off fucking some guy in the bathroom. Come out, I'll be warm. And it's like, gone. It's fucking ridiculous. It's not so good for my abandonment issues. But then, you know, I was thinking about the sun, and it made me think about the Earth and this whole, like, flat Earth conspiracy.
Yeah.
I was thinking to myself, what if the flat Earthers are right? What if the Earth really is flat, but, like, her contour game is just really on point? You guys know the levels of makeup, by the way, though, right? Natural, glam, and witness protection program. But I, you know, I try to look nice, but I do the best that I can. That has its own problems, though. Like, the other day, I just stopped at McDonald's, let's say, for a coffee. So, like, while I'm standing there, I hear this guy behind me, and he's like, "Excuse me, do you have a boy toy?" I just put around, and I was like, "You motherfucker." Turned out he was trying to get exchange a toy for the Happy Meal. It's good to be a kid. You should be able to play with whatever toys you want. You know, yeah. The difference between being a kid and being an adult? The different, like, if you're a kid and you get C's and D's, you're probably in trouble. But if you're an adult and you get C's and D's, you probably are trouble. So I'm going to finish up tonight by, I don't know if you guys follow current events or not, but I saw that thing about the defunct Chinese space station that was like going to crash, it was like a few weeks ago, it was going to crash back to the planet. This made me think about my definition of hope, and I want to leave you all with this. Because, you know, they were talking about it, like this Chinese is going to crash back into the planet, right? And so they said it's 1 in 1,000,000 that it doesn't burn up in the atmosphere. Right, so there's like 1 in 1,000,000 chance that it hits somewhere on the planet. But then don't worry, because it's only 1 in 1,000,000,000 that it hits like somewhere populated. And it's only 1 in a trillion chance that it actually hits somebody. And I thought to myself, that means there's a 1 in a trillion chance that this fiery, you know, piece of metal could actually crash to the planet and crush my ex.
Yeah.
And that's the definition of hope. And hope is a beautiful thing.
Yeah,